Hello, how are you guys doing? Well, Happy New Year. So basically, what do you guys think? $554 for a new car payment a month and $391 for a car payment. And I'm paying $384 for my car payments. So let's see. What do you think about this webinar on how to pay off your car loan in 36 months without giving up Starbucks? I'm on my way into Albertsons to go to Starbucks or being cheap. So let me tell you, when you sign up for my program, you're going to get instant access to my six-week mastery class. And it's only going to cost like $4,000. It has a value of $4,997. As part of this package, you're going to get my secret video. I was going to hold it back, but I'm going to give it to you. It's by Grant Cardone, and I entitled it How to Raise $15 Million in 90 Minutes, and he's going to teach you some of the best ways. If you need to raise some money, take these strategies and use them. Especially some of you guys who have like that 69-month car payment. Remember the lesson from yesterday? I'll go over it again another time. Remember, car depreciates in 60 months. So if you have a 69-month car loan, basically your car is worth zero and you're giving the insurance company free money. Basically, what I'm trying to tell you, when you have that tool, you're going to be able to go out and learn how to accumulate extra money to pay off your car quicker. In addition, you'll learn this tool will help you get rid of family members and friends that are costing you money. Basically, what I'm trying to say, when I was trying to figure this out, man, I was like, I had problems like telling family members no, having problems telling friends no. So what I had to do was like, basically, I had to recreate my own belief through the lesson of hard knocks. And I don't want you to have to go through that. See, what I'm talking about, way back then, back in about 2007, I ended up spending over like $40,000 in bank fees for probate. I ended up spending money, lawyer fees to like, that was about $20,000 because I made a mistake. My grandmother and I made a mistake on a will form, and we wanted to get the uncle out the form, but she passed away before I could correct it with her help, and she ended up passing away. So I ended up spending about $20,000 minimum. It was a lot for like the probate fees to make sure the uncle didn't get the house because she didn't want him to do it because he was a drug addict. And then on top of it, we had a friend of the family who moved into the house, and I ended up thinking that she would pay the bills on the house, and she didn't pay the bills on the house. So I ended up having to come out of pocket for about $2,575 to pay back 6 months worth of housing payments. And that's not counting the what I had to pay the city of Los Angeles, because you have to pay the tax every 6 months. So I had to pay the tax on that. And then just thinking about like the years, I think it took 3 years. I was driving from my house in San Bernardino to try to pick up a rent check from Sister Flo. And then we'd get in the car, drive around for a few minutes. And she's like, oh, so-and-so is not here. So instead of giving you the $300 that I owe you, I'm only going to give you $80 or $100. But we had signed a lease for $300. She had a two-bedroom, one-bedroom house for $200. I know it was the hood. But even though it was the hood, you tell me a place that you get that cheap in the inner city. I don't care how many drugs you sell. That was the best deal in town. And what did she do? Screw it up. And then she didn't help with repairs. So I don't want you to go to those. So basically what I'm telling you, what these tools are going to do is going to help you just save you, not only save you time and money, but just save you stress and frustration. So let me just tell you. When you use this tools that I'm going to give you, not only are you going to save time and money that I spent to develop. It took me 4 years to develop what I'm going to give you. And basically what you're going to be doing is you're going to be avoiding a trial and error of what I did of trying to figure out how to pay for like a car payment while I'm also paying a lawyer. I'm paying not only my house note, but another house note, lawyer fees. I'm paying extra taxes. So do you want to go through that, how I got myself in that situation? Why don't you take everything I learned, take that, bottle it up, throw that, take it, customize it to what you have, and then throw it at your car payment. I think if you take at least half of what I'm telling you, and if you guys are stuck with the 69-month car payment, you could at least get it down to 48 months. So let's say that's 48 months, so that's 21 times. Say if you have a new car, that's $554. That's almost $20,000. You're paying me $4,997 to save you a net of $16,000 in your pocket. And then if you want to take that car and trade it in, it still will be worth something. Do you think that's worth it? I think it's worth it. So basically, let me tell you a little story. Back in 2007, my mom passed away. And when she passed away, I took some of her money. I went out and bought myself a 2007 325 CI Beamer. Well, I paid off the Beamer, like paid off about half of it. The car cost about, when it was all said and done, it was like $43,000 for like the metallic gray. Luckily for me, I was able to pay off the car within like an extra 2 months after what I put down from what the inheritance was. But what I learned, when you have a luxury car, you have a lot of repairs. First thing that what happened to me was, like when I tell you I spent $7,000 for a gallon of gas, the fuel pump went out on the Beamer BMW. So I was cruising on the I-10 freeway, and then all of a sudden the car cut out, and luckily I was able to glide over to the side, $7,000. Another issue, I had like a low profile car. I hit something on the road. It threw a bunch of wires off. That cost me, I think it was like $359. Then another issue I had as the car got older, the brake line started to leak. So that was like $795. But then every 2 months, I would be taking that car to the dealer. It at least cost me $300 to get it out. Minimum $198 for them to do the inspection, but then they have to do the repair. So the reason I'm saying is, like, I know some of you guys have car payments, and I'm talking especially you guys with these luxury cars. I could not imagine having a $554, that's minimum from the Credit Karma, of what they're saying a new car was, and new car monthly payment was in 2019. But then also having to do repairs too. Man, you must be stressed. Are you stressed? I would be stressed. I was stressed with no car payments during repairs. Now I can imagine having car payments and during repairs. That warranty is basically useless. A warranty only covers like some stuff that's really manufactured. So I'm not going to even count the warranty stuff because that's basically useless. So that's what I'm saying, man. Do you really want to be making car payments for almost 7 years? That's crazy, man. Don't do that to yourself, man. Go back and watch the video. Read how I talked about how you spend $554 a month, $381. Look at those numbers and just like do the math. And then go to your IRS book and see how your car depreciates in 16 months. That means if you get into a car accident in 60 months prior it, you get zero. But you still owe payments on the car. The car company and the insurance company are making money off you. And all you're doing is just paying for like a rock. So $4,997. That's what the value of this master program is going to be. So look at the video I just did like yesterday, New Year's Eve. And just decide, hey, do you want to have a car payment for 7 years, 6.5 years? Or hey, man, I'll pay Martin, 4 or 5 months worth of car payments to net $18,000, $19,000, $20,000. You decide.